What's up YouTube? Today we're talking about max badges on my two-way mid-range finisher. This is the tallest center belt that I have. He has 7'3 max weight. You see I have 6 finishing. You may think that's not enough, but I use pro touch and deep hooks. This helps me hit my hook shots, and then I like to fade, I like to shimmy fade, all that other stuff. So this is the perfect finishing combination. Sometimes I'll put on back down punisher. I could really throw people around in the paint. Sometimes I'll put on consistent just to help with the layups, or sometimes I'll even put on contact just to get those big standing dunks under the rim. But the way I play deep hooks gold and pro touch gold is perfect for helping me hit all the post hooks I take. With the shooting badge, every single one of these badges helps with my post fades and my shooting. Dead eye helps me hit contested deep fades. I like to fade from the free throw line, I cannot lie, and that helps it every bit. Hot zone hunter, I have hot spots all over the post, you know, the mid range, the 3 points, everywhere I shoot, so that helps. Range extender and quick draw, I like to shoot far, I like to shoot fast. And then green machine, once I start greening post fades and 3 pointers, I keep greening those shots. That is the best setup I like for my post score. With the playmaking badges, quick first step gold. I'm 7'3 in max weight, so I should be slow, but whenever I have the ball with the quick first step gold, I'm able to get a pretty fast first step on people. It's unexpected and they can't guard it most of the time. And then I use post spin gold, of course you guys know, just to hit them with the post spins. It helps you stop getting stripped whenever you're spinning. Sometimes I'll put on unpluckable, and then sometimes if I'm playing threes or twos and I have a teammate, I'll take off post spin and I'll put on needle threader, bailout, and unpluckable all on bronze. That helps me with the passes and not getting plucked, but most of the time I like to use this build as a 1v1 build, so post spin gold. If you thought you heard some meows, you are not crazy. That was a cat. Well, we are back. Pogo stick gold for defense, rim protector to get those good block animations, and this helps you get snatch blocks. Chase down artist, so if someone beats you, you can actually chase down their shot and get a block. And then clamps on bronze, just if I'm playing people, I can bump them, make them pick up the ball sometimes. If I'm playing twos or threes, sometimes I'll put that on Intimidator, but I like to run clamps. Now 6'6", 6'6", and 24, you may want more defense, but I wanted to be able to have post moves upgraded and some finishing upgraded so I can dominate all assets of the post score. You know, they got their stats, it's separated in playmaking, finishing, and shooting, so it's kind of tough to perfectly balance it out, but since I'm so tall, 6 defensive badges actually works well. So you see here, I'm going to be showing you guys going up against a dude in a suit. How did he get this suit? Because he's only a superstar 3. We will never know, but he's super fast. He's the offensive threat, the best offensive build in the game. And I want to show you guys this build. You know, you've seen me fade, you've seen me hook, you've seen me do all the finesse post scoring stuff, but you may not think that I can actually, post spin people, drop step people, dominate the paint with this build just because my finishing isn't the highest. Well, these gameplays, I'm going to show you that you definitely can dominate the paint. people underrate height. You know, if you're going up against a guard and you're 7'3", it doesn't matter if your strength's low, even though my strength's super high. It doesn't matter any of that stuff. If you have the height on somebody, that's an advantage in itself. If you have the weight on somebody, that's an advantage in itself. You see right here, getting an easy layup to start. Gonna hit him with the big free throw line post hook right there. I'm telling you, Deep Hooks Gold and Pro Touch Gold makes hooks basically automatic. Even if you're widening, hooks are gonna go in at a consistent level. Hit him with the post spin right there. You see post spin technician gold popping up. I don't have the highest post moves in the world. You know, it's in the 80s. Nothing too crazy, but since I'm going up against a guard, it's gonna throw him out of the way pretty much every time. Every single guard's gonna get bullied. Even a two-way slash and playmaker, they may think they have the defense, but they are too short. You see right there, he tries to pull the chair. Sometimes that works, but a lot of the time it doesn't. And usually when it doesn't, that just gives you a free layup, and that's exactly what happened right there. Now I have my post scoring takeover. Now, you know, everything is amplified by 100. Now I'm just really gonna be tough. You see, he's backing up. He doesn't know what he's gonna do. Hit him with the big drop step right there. Throw him out of the way. Like I said, I got 6 finishing badges. I don't have drop stepper on at all. But once you get that post scoring takeover, you can basically consistently drop step. Hit him with the fade right there. Jump back. Mistime it, mess it up. Usually that goes in 90% of the time with post scoring takeover. But I mess it up. Now I gotta play some defense, you know. Well, what's this build without playing defense? Now that's one thing right there. You know, you may think, how do you ever keep up with guards with a 7'3 center max weight, as I hit him with the post hook right there. Missing, looking bad, he fouls me, gotta reset, gotta start hitting my shots. But you may think, how do you guard any guard that's so fast when you're so slow on a big? To be honest, as long as you're just kind of near him like I was right there, I didn't contest him, but just because I was near him, he got nervous, he missed a shot, and, you know, rarely are you going to play people that can hit every single shot if you're just there. You know, it's going to make them nervous, it's going to disrupt their shot, and they're going to miss, and they're more likely to miss than you are. Now, I know, look at me, you know, I'm missing shots like crazy right now. You know, that usually doesn't happen. I usually hit every shot. I'm close to the basket. I just wanted to show this gameplay so I could actually show you guys this build playing some defense, because I know, you know, 7'3s are not popular this year. People like me, and, you know, anywhere from like 6'9 to 6'11 to have the speed, to have the acceleration. And that's definitely nice to have on defense, you know, if you're playing twos, threes, anything like that. Like I said, leave guards open. As long as you're kind of there, they're going to be nervous and they're going to miss shots. 7'3s are not the most ideal, but making a post score like this, especially with a pure green pie chart with the shooting, it definitely helps to have height, to have the extra strength that comes with it, have the high interior defense. It makes for a good 1v1 build. And a good 2v2 build if you have a lock, you know, someone that can cover up your defensive liabilities. And he pulls a chair, like I said, you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. He got me right there. Had to play defense, you know, 4 or 5 times, and I've gotten the ball back. He's leaving me wide open. He thinks I'm just a post scorer that can't shoot, so I got to show him with the green right there. 2-17. I mean, if he can get the ball 5 times and he's not able to take advantage of my strength, and then, you know, what are you doing, man? That's the one thing he has is the speed. He should be like, I need to get a couple stops and it'll be game. He's messed it up 5 times, which is unfortunate. 2-19 now. Post spin, hit him a little bit. Contested late, 40%. A pro touch helps with those. And get him out of here, man. Now look at this. He decided to take off his shirt and come back. Offensive threat, same dude. I mean, hey, maybe he thought the suit was weighing him down. It was, you know, making him stiff. He couldn't move very well. And he's coming back for the rematch. This time, I get the ball first. The first time, he had the ball first. We will see if it makes a difference. We will see if he can get a stop. We'll see if he can predict how I can play, because I didn't do anything too crazy that game, to be honest. I was mainly backing him down in the paint, hitting layups. I shot a couple hook shots. I missed a fade. We'll see how he's playing me now. He does know how to pull the chair, so shout out to him. People, you know, people get mad about people pulling the chair. People refuse to do it. But pulling the chair definitely is a great way to guard a big man. Now, you can kind of counter that. Like, if I be post-spinning, he can't really pull the chair on a post-spin. You see right there, you know, push him back, got a little big boy push animation, so I just go up with the easy layup. It doesn't matter, he's not going to contest those, and you know, they're going to go in 99% of the time. Same thing right here, drop step, he's in the air late, 4% contested, 6-0, I almost have my takeover all the way up, and I'm not even really doing post moves, I'm just throwing up some layups. That's how easy it is to get post scoring takeover. Hit him with the spin right there, little shimmy hook. If you guys don't know how to shimmy hook, I made a video on it, I showed the best one. And I'm going to be showing how to shimmy fade all those post moves. So definitely check him out if you guys haven't. He tries to, you know, hit me with a pull the chair right there. He's trying like crazy. Hit him with a little shimmy over the shoulder. Was going to hit that one too, but he fouls me. 8-0. Now I have my post corner takeover. You see quick first step popping up. Hit him with the post spin. Hit him with the little step back post fade. When you're that close to the basket, you do not have to green. You see deep fades just popping up for that little post fade, which is crazy. Hey, it goes in. Like I said, post corner takeover just makes you hit things like crazy. Hit him with the big boy post spin, knocks him out of the way. It's always late a lot of the time when you're in there the basket. That's where consistent finisher will pop up. Anytime you shoot a late layup, consistent will help that. But like I said, I only have, you know, 6 finishing badges, so I like to use it on my hooks when I did it. Drop step right there, slightly early, 2% contested. I mean, it doesn't matter. I'm so close to the hoop. I'm gonna hit those. He's gotta find a way to get a stop. He's not really gonna be able to block me or anything. He probably needs to pull the chair. Hit him with a shimmy fade right there. Hit him with the shimmy hook. Gotta hit him with the shimmy fade. Gotta show him a little bit of everything at this point. I mean, it's looking like the suit may have been the better thing because he's just getting broken right there. I'm getting the big slam dunk animation right there. This build does not have any driving dunk, but the standing dunk is max. So, I mean, realistically, I can get under the hoop and standing dunk every time. But who wants to see that? Hit him with the shimmy fade right there. I finally do mess up. He finally gets the ball. Let's see if he's ready to go off offensively. Now, I'm here, you know. I got to dare him to shoot one. He was missing last game. He takes it. He hits a white. That's fine, you know, if he's going to be hitting wides, I gotta live with that a little bit. I am very slow, I just can't really let him get easy pank tanks. You see I'm there, I'm ready to step up anytime I think he's going to shoot. He does it again, full whites. He wasn't having it that time. Now, luckily, I fumble the ball, and he gets it right back. We'll see what he can do. See, he beats me to the basket right there. Chase down artist bronze helps a lot when stuff like that happens. Sometimes I'll get a block right there. He got the dunk right there. Nothing you can do. 5-18. Let's see what he's got. I mean, he's got pretty decent dribble moves. He gets a 3 right there. He's starting to cook up. He got the green. He's got the momentum. So now it's all on him. If he can hit his shots, he might have a chance to win. I need to play better defense, though, to be honest. I was kind of daring him to shoot a little bit too much. I come up a little bit, like I said, that intimidator. I mean, I don't have intimidator on. But he himself was intimidated just by me coming up right there. That's the best defense you can play when you're a 7-3 center. Now 8-18. He's not touching the ball again at this point. You know, I've been playing around. Post spin right there. It's the same thing. Hit him with the drop step. He jumps right there very early. 100% smothered. That was completely on me. You know, I could have done a lot of things. And instead, I forced up something contested. I said he wasn't going to get the ball back. And he got it twice. That's the second time I ran into him. I mean, that, to be avoided, I just need to get away from hold LT. I was being really careless with the ball, showing you my defense. Able to get a poke right there. Amazing. This build, you know, it doesn't really have any steel, but I was able to make it work. Just drive to the paint, hit him with the easy lay, 8-20. Let me know what you guys think of the build. You know, I made this pretty early in the year. Would I have made any changes? I mean, I like how I made it. A lot of people make the blue, yellow pie chart. I like being a post score with this pure yellow, blue yellow, blue green. I like the pure green. It's a little bit different. Yeah, but let me know what you guys think. This is Tonic. Catch you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace.